Hey Toy Collector fans, this is Fly Guy. We continue on with this bad boy wave, the Hulkbuster Marvel Legends 6-inch figure wave, and we're going to look at Thundra next. It's one of the females in the Marvel Legends line. This is the outer of the box, and she is not named on the box. She shares a package with Marvel's Valkyrie, and it just says Fearless Defenders. We got a pretty nice shiny Legends pack. And up at the top, it just says Build-A-Figure Hulkbuster, Marvel, etc. And on the side, you'll get to see the image over there. A very cool, very sultry pose there from her with her ball and chain. Don't mess with her, I'll tell you. On the back, you'll see all of the parts required to build the Hulkbuster, all of which is reviewed. All of these figures will be reviewed and on our channel and in a playlist just for Marvel Legends. And there we go, there's some of the other of the two figures that are in this shared pack. There's Thundra there, and there is Valkyrie, who we just reviewed as well. A little text if you want to freeze frame and read it in multiple languages. And on with the show. This is a cool looking figure. It's definitely one, again, that is, of course, just like all Marvel Legends figures, generically done, but still packs a punch, looks good. Nice sculpting and detail. Again, I believe she's using the Mystique body that we've seen many times before. We'll get some nice gold Shazam looking like colouring and transfers on the side of the thighs, and she's got some gold coloured booties, and obviously that ball and chain, which we'll talk about in a minute, which looks great. It's got some silver and some weathering applied, there we go, or dry brushing I should call it. And let's get a look at the rest of her for a minute. She does come with this kind of gold chain, which is kind of or the gold paint of a chain, across her chest up there. And it goes round underneath the hair, and you'll see there's a peg hole at the back for nothing. It's just the way that it happens. They often leave the peg holes there for pretty much all of the figures. So we get a nice sculpt on the hair. It's very well done. Very flowing, very just stepped out of the salon. But does look good. And she's got a very gritted teeth look there and a little tiara-like piece. But I think that's an excellent facial sculpt. That's almost, it could be kind of stolen for a Black Widow, like with the hair colour and so forth, some customs out there. But it looks pretty good. Unfortunately, with all of the figures that tend to have this flowing, I've just been to the salon here, it makes it incredibly hard to move. And that is the case with this. You ain't going nowhere really with her head. It just, that's it in terms of articulation. Her head will pop off eventually, and you'll see, just like the Marvel's Valkyrie, it's just a ball joint there. There is no peg, no movement, no nothing. That's the way it is. So a very cherry red colour on her outfit there and chesticles. And if I pop that back on, you'll see just the rest of the figure. So there's really not a great deal else coming on. It's a belt which is not removable, but movable as such, and moves up and down. But nice little touches and details. The silver is good. The black little indents of the holes on the belt is good. Do like that. But that's it for really highlights and details. So articulation-wise, she is pretty basic. Not a great deal going on in that head. It's pretty locked, as I said. Ball joint up at the top of the arms, which allows the arm to move pretty well. You get a fair bit of movement going on there. Swivel bicep, we've got a ball joint with a hinge at the elbow, and down to the wrist, you can see the joints there. It's a swivel and a peg that allows it to move back and forth. So plenty of movement going on there. On the upper torso, she's got a fair bit of movement, but that looks ridiculous. But that's the way it goes, and plenty of ab crunch. She's been going to the gym and watching her calories there. And no swivel waist, there is no extra waist, it's all this upper torso. And you'll see the ball joint there up at the top with the peg, which allows that to move on the thighs. We've got swivel thighs as well up at the top. Double joints at the knees. We've got the rocking ankles, and of course peg holes down at the bottom. So that is it for her. One other thing is a weapon, which I just showed you. So looks very much like something at the Wrecking Crew. They've done an excellent job here on the chain. I love when they do this dry brushing and just make it look metallic. It rocks. It's a really, really nice job done there on the ball and chain going on all the way down to the ball. Looks excellent. I really like that. It's got a really nice kind of crushed metallic look, and love that stuff. Such a sucker for silver paint. I should be a magpie. Anything chromey or silver, I'm just like, ooh, love it. Like, that's it. It's a pretty straightforward figure. Another one in this wave. But again, a lot of people want to collect this figure. What do you think? Is it one for you? You want to collect Thundra? Is she one you've longed for long enough? She's going to be pretty popular, I would imagine. So, again, love to hear your thoughts on her. What do you think of Marvel's Thundra? Is it one you want to collect? Please do leave a comment below. Again, if I have never read a Thundra comic in my life. I do know she came out about 1992, I think. I might be completely wrong, but I believe it wasn't that long ago. No, tell a lie, she was 70. She was in the 70s. 1972 Thundra came out. She's quite an old school gal, so she's been around for quite a while. But again, I'd love to know your thoughts. If there's a good comic that I should be reading for Thundra, is there anything good about Cact? I don't know much about her, but again, love to hear your thoughts. Please do leave a comment below if you want to buy this Hulkbuster wave. Click the link directly underneath the video, take it to darksidetoys.com where you can pick it up. They appear to be the only place to get this wave, first of all. No one else appears to have got them yet. So there you go. We only got a limited amount though. It is very small, but it is coming in periodic drips and drabs. So Hasbro keep delivering more and more stock all the time. So hang in there. They will be coming through all the way through from now, all the way through to July, sorry, to August. So only 4 weeks till August, 4 or 5 weeks to August. So that's it for this review. If you're brand new to the channel, click subscribe. You'll get Marvel Legends and Star Wars and DC and all sorts of other stuff straight into your inbox. And we'll be back for another Marvel Legends review coming up soon. Cheers.